Hello, in this movie I would like to do families called profile. So to get started, let's jump into the Revit under the families. Now in my look I want to browse down until I find profile hosted. It's here. Once I select it, I'm gonna click it on open and here we go. Now we'll notice that we have two reference planes. They are the most important part of the Revit family. First and foremost, we add reference planes, we dimension them, and then we'll put our 3D extrusion or line work on the top reference planes. Now since it's gonna be kinda small profile, I want to change my scale instead 1:10 to 1:5. Alright, let's get started. What I want to do is I want to create a reference plane. So everything we do in the family is going to build off the two reference planes that are already here. To do it, easiest way to make another reference plane, I think, is to select one of that already them, right click and create similar. Now on my job panel, I wanna click on my big lines bottom and I'm gonna give the offset 300 millimeters, and I'm gonna hover over this reference plane. Notice that my reference plane is going to shoot to the right. Now let's do one down. I'm gonna pick here and offset it downward. Excellent. I get lost it in reference planes. On my measure panel, I'm gonna click on my align dimension button. Now it's very important the order is which with dimension, because this is considered our strong reference plane. This defines the original right here. This is the insertion point. So when we dimension something, we have to go from the strong reference to weak reference, because if this dimension changes, I want to this line to move, not this line. So dimension from your strong reference to weak reference. Now just pick off to do the same, going to down, go from strong reference to weak reference and pick off. Now we need to add new parameters to our dimension. If we will click to family type, add parameter. For the name I wanna call it depth. We want it to be type, so let's click it OK. Now let's create new parameter. Height. Now we have to keep it this type parameter, because we're gonna involve this in mathematical formula with our depth parameter. Let's click OK. OK. And let's give it label. For that one we will give depth. For this one, height. Now I wanna have that little 50 millimeters revolve here and here. So I gonna click right, create similar, offset 50 millimeters, and on my draw panel let's click pick line here and here. Escape couple of time, go to dimension, align, let's click it here, click it off here and click it off. Let's go to family type and let's create new parameter. Let's call it reveal. Okay, and now choose that one, control key, that one, label, and reveal. Okay, let's draw our line. First we'll choose line, we'll start from here, 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 and now on the draw panel let's choose the start and radius arc. And let's on the fixed position click it and done. Escape couple of time. Now let's go to family type and let's go to create formula. For the height I want it be same with depth, so I will write depth here. For the reveal, depth smaller than 20, the our reveal it's 2 millimeter. If not, it 5. And parentheses. Apply. Okay. So as you see, we created the formula. Let's change a bit our formula. For example, let's change to our depth to 200, and here 20, and here 50. Yes. And let's change it to 600. Apply. Yeah, this is much better. Let's go back to 300. Apply. Yeah, let's leave it like that. And now, let's create some few family types. Go to family type, click on this button, and let's create 300 millimeters. Okay, let's create new one. 600 millimeters. Let's click OK and let's change it to 600 millimeters and apply. Now if you click down on this one you will see changing here. Okay, for this stage we will save this family. Let's give the name cove, options, one maximum backups. Okay, save it and let's open project. Hit your project. Okay, let's create few walls. Let's change this one rectangle. It doesn't matter now about our wall. Let's go to 3D to see it more properly and find details. Okay, for now we should load our cove into the project. Go back by this one to cove project and load into the project. Choose our the wall, edit type. Let's open preview and let's choose the section to see more properly. And edit structure. Let's add the sweeps. Load profile. Oh, we already loaded. So add profile. And choose our cove. For example, 600 for this one. Material, let's make it concrete. Let's make it concrete. Okay. And offset from the top like 100 millimeters. Okay. Oh, actually it's from the bottom. So let's change it. Here is 0. It's from the base. Apply. Apply. From the top. Yeah. Okay, okay. And okay. And as you see, we get our profile sweeps on the our wall. And now we can actually go here again, sweeps, and we can change the our dimensions here. As you see, it's changed.